Good morning everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Leaf Classes. I am Anjali. Today's video is about sorting. Yes, what is sorting? Sorting means arrangement. Arrangement in some particular order. It can be ascending order, it can be descending order, right? So there are different techniques of sorting. That means how to arrange the elements in array in different order. Different techniques are there. We have selection sorting, bubble sorting, merge sorting, heap sorting. Different techniques are there. And as per your syllabus for the session 2021, you have only bubble sort technique. So we will be doing bubble sort technique only in this video, and I hope all of you will understand it properly. And children, please revise and do the written practice once to make it more clear. Till you will not do written practice, it will be little difficult for you during the examination time to write. So it's my request to all of you to do the written practice. Before telling you the program, I would like to tell you the steps how the sorting process takes place in this technique. So first we will do the steps and then I will tell you the programming statement. So let's begin with the steps. The question can be asked for bubble sorting to arrange the array elements in either ascending order or in descending order, and the size of the array is normally given in the question, maybe 10 or 20, like that it is given. But here for the explanation, I have just taken 5 array elements. That means the array size is 5, and I will tell you how the processing will take place for ascending as well as descending order. So I have taken here 5 elements. The subscript, you know, always starts from 0, and the last subscript of the array is size minus 1. So if size is 5, the last subscript is 5 minus 1, that is 4. So array elements are 14, 6, 21, 1 and 8. First we will do for sorting in ascending order. In bubble sort, the comparison is done between two adjacent subscripts, and in ascending order, the elements are to be sorted from smaller to bigger element. So if the next element is smaller, but we want it towards the left side. So if the next is smaller, swap it that time only. So here the swapping takes place when the comparison is done. So if the next element is smaller, it has to be bigger, right? If it is smaller, then swap the elements and then do the next comparison, like that it will take place. So let me explain you 14 and 6. We want it in ascending order. So 6 is smaller. So in ascending order, 6 has to come to the left side. So that time only swapping will take place. 6, 14, 21, 1 and 8. Alright. One time only one swapping will take place. Then 14 and 21. 14 is smaller, 21 is bigger. No swapping. Because 14 is already smaller. We want that, right? So here the same elements we will get, 14 and 21. Now 21 and 8, between 2 and 3. 1 is smaller, so it has to swap, 1 and 21. And then after this, the comparison will be between 21 and 8. So here the next element is smaller, so we will get the next element we will swap, and the highest element, the biggest element, we will get towards the right side in the last subscript of the array, right? So after one complete pass, what we are getting? The highest element towards the right side. Now for the remaining thing, what we will do from next iteration, only we have to take care of rest of the elements leaving the rightmost. After one complete more pass, the second highest will come to the second last script subscript, and like this we will be comparing adjacent items, and wherever the condition is satisfied, we will swap it that time. So how it is done? The comparison is done between 0, 1, then 1, 2, then 2, 3, then 3, 4. Like that the comparison is done. Now let us see for descending order. Descending order means from the biggest
two smallest element, right? Biggest to smallest, and here I have taken the same elements 14, 6, 21, 1 and 8. Here also the comparison will be between 0, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, like that the comparison will take place. Now first 14 and 6. We want the bigger element towards the left side because we have to come from bigger to smaller, right? So 14 and 6, there will be no change. 14 is already bigger. So here we will get the same elements. Now 6 and 21. Yes, 21 is the bigger value. So swapping will take place. You will get 21, 6, 1, 8. Right? Now the comparison will be between 2 and 3. So you will get 6 and 1. No change because already 6 is bigger. So here we will get 6, 1, and now the comparison will be between 3 and 4 subscript. So what you will get here, 8 and 1. Now here what you have got, the lowest or the smallest element, right? And here you got the biggest element. There you got the smallest element after one complete pass in descending order. And after this, what we have to do, we will be repeating the process for the remaining elements and then we will get the next smallest like that. And here we have got the biggest. So in ascending order, after one complete pass, you will get the biggest element towards the last side. And in descending order, you get the smallest element in the last subscript of the array. So like this, it takes place. Children, here I would like to tell you one more thing. Sometimes in section A also the question is asked, how many iterations are required for the complete process of bubble sorting? So if the array size is n, suppose the array size is n, then you need factorial n minus 1 iterations. That means suppose you have 5 elements in the array, then you need factorial 5 minus 1, that is 4. That means 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So 4, 3 is a 12, 2 is a 24 iterations are required. So just remember the formula factorial n minus 1, where n is the size of the array. So we can just verify it from here also. If the array size is 5, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 times for the first pass, then second time, it will be 3 times, then 2 times, then 1 time. So just remember the formula and that's it. Now we will do the program for bubble sorting. And since the logic is clear to you, there will be no problem in understanding the programming statements. Before we proceed, I would like to tell you about an event of Unacademy. Yes, it is a revision marathon, one day revision marathon by the topmost educators of Unacademy for our learners of class 10th and 12th board examination especially. And it is mainly for the subjects maths and science. So just ask your doubts live and your enrollment is free. Please go to the description box for the enrollment link, enroll yourself, attend the live sessions by the topmost educators, and not only this, the winners will be awarded Unacademy Plus subscription for 1 month by Unacademy. So don't forget, date is 21st February 2021, timing 10 a.m. to 8:30 p.m. and enrollment is free. Just grab the opportunity. Best wishes to each one of you. Stay blessed. First, we are doing for 10 elements array size of integer type and to sort it in ascending order. Since we have to input the array element, so I have taken java.util package so that we can use the scanner class functions, and within the main first we have created the object of scanner class, and after that the declaration of array A of size 10 is there. Then I have written the message enter 10 integers. Children, whenever you have to enter array elements and you want to give the message, always give the message before starting the loop. Otherwise, so many times the same message will be repeated if you will give that within the loop. So give the message before the loop, enter 10 integers, and then we have taken the loop from 0 to less than 10. Always remember that whenever you have to input the array elements, the loop must start from 0 and till less than the size. That means if total 10 elements we have to enter, it should go from 0 to 9. So here you can write less than 10 also or less than equals to 9. Both are correct, right? And then AI equals to SC dot next INT. Next INT is the function to input integer type values. And since it is not the normal INT variable, it is integer array variable. So here we have taken the subscript within the square brackets. Right, this is the entry portion, how you will input the array elements. Now we come to the sorting part. So if the size is 10, the outer loop, always remember for sorting you have to use nested loop. Entry will be using single loop, sorting process will take place using nested loop. So the outer loop will start from 0 to less than size minus 1. If size is 5, first pass, how many iterations? 4 iterations. So if size is 10, first time, how many iterations? 9 iterations. That means from 0 to 8, right? So the outer loop will be from 0 to less than 9. And always the comparison is between two adjacent items. So the comparison will take place using the inner loop variable J. And here the loop will start from 0. Always remember, I and J, both the loops will start from 0. And this will be 9 minus I. Because every time we are shifting the highest elements towards the right side, so that will not be taken into the next loop, right? So here we will do the comparison. If A, J plus 1, that means the next element, right, is smaller than AJ, then we have to do the swapping. So when this condition is true, do the swapping that time only. So for swapping, we have used a temporary variable. Here I have declared T. Temporary variable holds the value for some period, and then wherever it is required, it can be transferred over there. So here you will store the value t equals to aj, and aj is equals to aj plus 1, and aj plus 1 is equals to t. Now here the trick I want to tell you, t equals to aj, now this will be here. The value of, suppose A1 you are storing in T, then in A1 you will store the value of A2. So this AJ, then next line will start from AJ. Then if it is AJ plus 1, this will begin from AJ plus 1 equals to T. So T equals to AJ, AJ equals to AJ plus 1, AJ plus 1 equals to T. Just remember that this and this should match, this and this should match, and T will be diagonally, right? So after this complete process, your sorting will be completed. And after that, if the question comes, write the program to input the array elements, sort it in ascending order using bubble sort technique, and display the sorted array. Even if display the sorted array is not asked, but you have to display, because without print statement, how the user will come to know that what is the output? So after this, you will display the sorted array, give the message system.out.println and sorted array, and for displaying the sorted array, again one loop will be used. So that loop will again start from 0 and less than size, so here it is less than 10. And you can display here system.out.println of AI and close this for, close main and then close class.
Children, this is the program for sorting in ascending order. Now, if the question comes that you have to sort it in descending order, right? The entire program remains same. Only one symbol, this will be changed to this. Only less than symbol will be replaced by greater than symbol, and you are done with descending order program, right? So just practice it. You need little practice for sorting program. Please do it once or twice. And in case of any problem, please watch the video again, and then you are always welcome to ask your doubts in the comment section. If you haven't subscribed the channel till now, please do subscribe and press the bell icon so that you get notifications for all the videos and no important topic is missed by you. You can join us on our Telegram channel also. The link is given in the description box. Keep practicing, keep working hard, keep solving the questions. God bless you, children.